Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of our Farming RPG series. Currently, whenever we talk to our NPCs, it will load up a dialogue from the character file and run it. How it currently works is that we have a set of conditions coded in that determines the right dialogue to pull out. Today we want to make this interaction more advanced, so that we are able to throw in conditions that can be as specific as we want by accessing the blackboard. For starters, let's put information of the location the player is currently in out there, so that we can easily access them on the blackboard. Next, we want to be able to set our conditions for our character scriptable object. To do that, we need to represent the data that we want to fetch from the blackboard. So I created a new struct, BlackboardEntryData. Minimally, this should take in a key and a value. The problem is that Unity is unable to represent the object variable that we currently use for our game's blackboard. Hence, we'll need to specify the value type and store the different values for each type separately. I made a function to retrieve the value of the class instance, and it will return the right variable depending on the value type it is supposed to represent. Next, we need to manage the dialogue lines together with the conditions. So I made a new script, dialogue condition. This will store the conditions needed to trigger the dialogue, along with the actual dialogue data. After adding it to the character data and seeing how it looks like in the inspector, I realized that it was quite messy and clunky. So let's change how it looks on the editor. At first I thought about making an editor script that directly modifies the look of the character data scriptable object, but then I realized we have to deal with a nested reorderable list, which is quite a hassle to deal with. So I thought it would make sense to modify the property draw instead. So I created a new script in the editor folder, Blackboard Entry Data Editor. Since we've updated our Unity version to 2023.2, I thought to use the UI toolkit just so that I wouldn't have to worry much about the positioning of GUI boxes, sizing and such. So how the script essentially works is by retrieving the value of each property, then plugging in a callback to render the correct field whenever we change the value type. The problem with UI Toolkit is that it refused to refresh the inspector once I changed the type, and so I spent hours trying to figure out what was wrong with it, and in the end I realized that everything would just refresh once I bound the field. So now that things look a lot cleaner on the editor, it's time to make the whole dialogue selection system work. Since we already had some dialogue selection logic in interactable character, I thought we should just leave whatever we have set up there, and just create an additional filter function to override any dialogue selected, with a more suitable one should additional conditions be met. This function should be positioned above the first meeting logic, since that dialogue takes precedence above everything else. I created a select dialogue function in Dialogue Manager, which will take in the current selected dialogue and a list of all dialogue conditions that we can override it with. And the priority for the dialogue is determined by how many conditions were set for it. And then we need a function to check if the dialogue condition meets the stipulated conditions. The logic of check conditions in dialogue condition is as follows. It will iterate through every condition one by one to check if they are met. This means that we need another function over on the blackboard to handle this comparison, compare value. It will retrieve the data from the blackboard and compare the values accordingly. Now we create some conditions. When Uncle Ben is at the forest, he should have a dialogue about fishing. And to demonstrate this system's capabilities with time, you should also say something in a store on a Friday. And for a condition concerning the player's relationship, he should, when Uncle Ben is spoken to with the player at two hearts, he should say something special as well. This brings us to a problem. The relationship data that we have with the NPC is stored as a NPC relationship state, and none of the value types that we specified in Blackboard entry data. So how do we access the specific properties within the NPC relationship state? This is why I added a way to pass the key in tryGetValue of the Blackboard, such that I can access the fields and properties specified with a dot. So in this example, it would be something like NPC relationship underscore Ben dot hearts or dot friendship points, which will result in retrieving the object NPC relationship underscore Ben, which is our NPC relationship state, and then you'll get the field hearts or friendship. This led me to create the getNestedObject function, which will help me to access the property of these classes via reflection. After a few hours of debugging and dealing with errors all over the place, I realized that the hearts property on our NPC relationship is not a property at all, but a function. So we need to change it to a property with a get function as such, and then it works. Also, while I was at it, I wanted to access time information, like the day of the week, you know, like Friday and so on. So I had the timestamp uploaded to Blackboard in Game State Manager and made day of the week a property instead of a function. Now the problem is that we can only access the properties of an object, but not the fields. The hour in the timestamp is stored as a field, so I modified the getNestedObject logic to accommodate that. Now everything is working well and good, but our time condition might be a bit too specific. For instance, I can only make Jeff say something when the hour is of value 10. So at exactly 10 o'clock, he will say good morning, or like it's 10 a.m, my bones tell me it's 10 a.m. But then it won't follow up after that, like 11 o'clock, the conditions no longer apply. So we need to add additional condition operators, such as equals, greater than, greater or equal to, less than or equal to, and so on. So I made another class, Blackboard Condition, to keep track of it. Over in game Blackboard, I added a comparison function to handle the value comparison, and I changed the logic accordingly. So now everything works. While playtesting, I realized that the clock was displaying 12 a.m. when it was supposed to be noon, so I had to get it fixed in UI Manager. And that's it for this part. I know that the recent parts are getting a lot more advanced, especially with this one, and it might get a little more difficult to understand the code, but that's inevitable with dealing with complexity like this. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this part, and we hope to see you next time.